The question is asking to draw out all constitutional isomers for C5H12O. Since this chemical formula fits in the general formula of CnH2NO, that means C5H12O can be an alcohol with OH group or an ether which has an oxygen sandwiched between two carbons. We're going to use a systematic way to draw out all the isomers, that way we won't be drawing randomly and miss out any structures. Let's start by drawing a 5-carbon chain alcohol, meaning 5 carbons connected straight in a row, and then we place OH at the first carbon. That will give us our first structure. We can then move the OH group to the second carbon like this, and then we move again to the third carbon, and that will give us our third structure. Now, if we move OH to the fourth and the fifth carbon, we'll essentially get back the first two structures that we have already drawn. So that's all for the 5-carbon chain. Moving on to 4-carbon chain alcohol, we draw 4 carbons straight in a row, and then we place that extra carbon, that 5th carbon, on carbon number 2. Let's start by placing OH on the first carbon, like this. And then working with the same 4-carbon chain, we're gonna move the OH to the second carbon like that. And then if we move it to the third carbon, it will also give us another isomer. So we're gonna keep that. And lastly, if we move the OH to the fourth carbon like that, it will give us yet another isomer. So we're gonna keep all of this. And it looks like we have exhausted all the possibilities for the 4-carbon chain. So that's all that we have. Now, can we move on to 3-carbon chain? Yep, looks like it's possible. So if we place 3 carbons straight in a row, the only way we can place the extra 2 carbons would be on carbon number 2. If we place them on the first carbon or the third carbon, we'll just end up drawing the structures that we have already drawn. So there's only one way to add the OH group, placing it on one of the carbons. So we've exhausted the 3-carbon chain. Do you see how we drew the alcohols in a systematic way? We started with 5-carbon chain, so we drew 5 carbons straight in a row, and then we start moving the OH from carbon number 1 all the way to carbon number 3. And then we exhausted all the possibilities. Then we move on to 4-carbon chain. So we have 4-carbon chain with the 5th carbon sticking on carbon number 2. So we keep that structure, and then we stick OH on carbon number 1, and then we keep moving it until we exhausted all possibilities. And then we move on to 3-carbon chain. Since it's impossible to have 2-carbon chain with 5 carbons, so we stop there at 3-carbon chain. Here are the 8 alcohols we have drawn. Let's move on to draw ethers. Start with 1 carbon before oxygen, then we place the remaining 4 carbons like this. So we have CO and then 4 carbons. Now, keeping this 1 carbon before oxygen, let's try out to see if we can shorten the 4 carbons at the end. We'll draw it in a different way, like this. CO and then 3 carbons, and then we stick the extra carbon on carbon number 1. So that's an isomer. Now, if we move that extra carbon to the second carbon, we will actually get a different isomer. Now, looks like we are done with this set. So let's explore placing 2 carbons before oxygen. And so that means we have 3 carbons after that. So we have 2 carbons before oxygen and 3 carbons after the oxygen. That's one way of drawing it. Repeating the same thing that we did with the previous set, let's shorten the carbon chain after oxygen. Let's make it 2 carbon and place that extra carbon like this. Since there's no other way we can shorten the chain at the back, we are pretty much done with this set. Do we need to draw 3 carbons before oxygen followed by 2 carbons, like meaning CCCOCC? Nope, because that would give us the same structure that we have already drawn. So that's all the ethers we can draw for C5H12O. Here's how they look like completed with hydrogens. We have a total of 5 ethers for C5H12O. Combined with the 8 alcohols that we have drawn, C5H12O has a total of 13 isomers. I hope you find the video helpful. Do subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.